Hello all. In this particular video, we are going to discuss about various techniques to handle missing data in a machine learning use case. Now, this particular step is very, very important, guys, because this is a step of feature engineering part, basically the feature engineering pipeline. And if we don't do this step very properly, then it may impact the accuracy of the model. So to begin with, guys, make sure you watch this video till the end, because I'm also going to show you the practical part and how we can implement it. So what we will do is that the agenda of this particular session will be seeing some theoretical information about the various techniques to handle missing data. Then we'll be seeing that which is the best technique to handle the missing data in a particular data set. And then finally, I'm going to show you a machine learning use case wherein we'll be handling the missing data and then applying a machine learning algorithm. So to begin with, guys, we basically have three different techniques of handling missing data. One is basically, I will just delete the record which has missing values. So delete the record which has missing values, okay? The second step basically is that I will create a separate model. I will create a separate model, okay, to handle the missing values. Just note down this particular, guys, because this is very, very important. And I will be explaining you each and every techniques very clearly. First, just let me write it down. The third technique is basically using some statistical methods. By using some statistical methods like mean, median, or mode, okay? I'll be replacing the NaN values with something else. But don't just consider that I'll be just taking a column and those value I'll just be replacing with the mean, median. But we also have to take care of some other things, which we'll be seeing in the practical session, what I'm going to take after this theoretical completion. Now, let us just focus on the first step, that is deleting the record, missing records. Now, suppose I have some features like F1, F2, F3, F4, okay? And this is my target output. So this F1, F2, F3 is my independent features. My output is basically my target feature. And suppose I have some values like 1, 2, blank, 4, 5, okay? F2 is having some values like 200, 300, okay, 400, 600, and 800. And similarly, I have some values in F3, and I also have some values in F4. Now, what I can consider is that I'm having some values over here, also like 100, again 50, it may be 20 over here, 10 over here. And suppose these are having some values like 70, okay, 80, and this is blank. Again, I'm taking it as 10 and 15, okay? Now we can see that in our third record, we don't have many values, okay? So whenever we have this kind of scenario wherein, suppose I have most of the records as empty, I mean, I have most of the features in a particular record as empty, what I can do is that I can delete this record, okay? I don't have to worry about it. I'll delete this record. But always remember, this step should be only followed when we have a huge data set. Now, when I say as a huge data set, that basically means that I'm talking about million of records, okay, for a machine learning use case. And there may be many, many records which will be empty. At that time, we can just delete the records because we have a huge data set altogether. Okay. So that will get incorporated with the other records, and that will give the same performance whenever we apply a machine learning algorithm. But if we have a small data set, we should never, never follow this particular approach, okay? Because each and every record in a particular data set specifies a huge amount of information, and that will help the model to learn about that particular data set more. But if you have a huge data set, if it just deletes some number of records that are having null values, it is fine. Now, let us go. This is about the first technique. Now you have understood when to apply this only when you have a particular huge data set. If you don't have a huge data set, I'll suggest you, please don't go with this particular approach. Now, the second technique is that I will create a separate model. Now, this is the most interesting part. Create a separate model. Now, what do we do with this creating a separate model? Always remember, guys, this usually takes much more time, and the computational effort is also more in this. Okay, now let us just understand what this is all about. Now suppose I have F1, F2, F3, F4, okay, and I have some of the missing values in this. Suppose my first record is having blank, my second value is basically in this particular feature values in this particular record is having some 20 value, 40 value, and I have my output value as 100. Similarly, I have some other values over here for F1 like 100, 150, 60, 40, and I have some values like 200 here. And similarly, I have like 50, 80, 90, 100, and I have like 300. And similarly, one more value. Let me just take an example like 70, 20, 10, 40, and finally, I have something like 100 here. Now, you see that there is one missing value over here, okay, for feature one. What we can do is that, always remember, whenever we, it is just like a same process. What we should do is that, whichever is having the missing value, I will consider that as my test data set. As my test data set. See, it is very important to understand what is this separate model all about, okay? What I will do is that, from this particular data set, which is having the missing value, I'll take, consider it as a test data set. And obviously, if I have a huge record, if I have many records, what will happen is that, I will have many features which will be having, suppose if in F1 I have around 100 data as my empty data set, basically for this particular value it is missing, okay? And for remaining 900, what I'll do is that I'll consider all this as my training data set, okay? I will consider this as all my training data set. Now from all this, I'll just skip this output. I don't require the output right now. What I can do is that I can consider my F2, F3, F4, I can consider F2, F3, and F4, okay? And I'll take these features and give it to my model. My model will get trained on this particular training data set, okay? On this particular training data set. And then, in this particular model, my F1 will be my output feature. My F1 will be my output feature. That basically means that, for my training data set, what I'm doing is that, I'm just giving F2, F3, F4 as my input features to my training model. And then the output feature, I'm considering it as F1, okay? And then after this model gets trained, what I do is that for this particular test data, like 20, 30, 40, I give it to as an input to my model and I get the output of this particular F1 value. After I do this particular technique, what I do is that for every test data, I try to fill the missing values, okay? So that is what I'm saying with respect to a separate model. But why it will take more time? Because suppose in F1 I have some empty value. In F2 feature also I may have some empty values. For all these features I have to create a separate model wherein I'll be changing my input features and my output features. Okay, I'm just going to skip this output, not required for this particular scenario. I'll just focus on that. I'll just take F2, F3, F4, or I can also take this output also. Okay, I can also take this output as my input feature in this along with this F1, F2, along with F2, F3, F4, I will also give my output as my input to my model and train it, considering my F1 is my output, and try to find out or predict what will be the output for this particular missing values. Again, not a very good technique because it usually takes much more time and the computational effort is also more. Okay, so I would prefer only when you have a smaller data set, you try to do this. Otherwise, no. Now let us go ahead and try to understand the third and the best technique. Why I'm saying this is as the best technique? Because it uses some statistical methods. Now, when I say statistical methods, always remember, guys, the first method that I will be using is mean. Second is basically called as median. And third is basically called as mode. Okay. I hope everybody knows mean. Mean is basically the simple average of all the, suppose in my feature, I have one value missing and I have like 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. I want to replace this value. What I'll do, I'll find out the average of all this. Okay. Median basically says that for all these values, after sorting it in an ascending order, suppose I sort it in an ascending order, whichever will be my central element, I will be replacing that NaN values or the missing value by that particular value. Okay. Mode basically says that the highest frequency of the value, suppose I have two 30s over here. Okay. So what I'll do is that whichever value is having the more frequency, I'll replace the NaN value with that particular value. Okay, so this will be completely dependent on frequency. Sorry. Now what we'll do is that, guys, we have understood all the three techniques. What I'm going to do is that I'm going to show you a practical application wherein I'll be using the statistical methods. Now I will just not be using mean, median or mode directly, but I'll show you that even though we are applying mean, what are all the other features that I have to depend on before I have to consider applying mean, median, or mode? Okay, so let us go ahead and try to understand the practical applications. So I'm just going to clear this and I'm going to go to my Jupyter notebook. There it is, my Jupyter notebook. In this particular example, what I'm doing is that I'm going to take a logistic regression example with the help of Titanic dataset, but there are some missing values. And don't worry about this particular this particular code, guys. I'll be uploading in the GitHub link. You can download the code from there itself. So in this logistic regression, I'm going to download the Titanic dataset. The link is given over here. You know, you can just download it and you can just try to use it. Okay. Now, suppose my Titanic dataset is over here. I'm going to read this. I'm going to see the head part. Now, as soon as I see the head part, you can see that there are some features called as cabin, which has NaN values. Okay. Similarly, as we go ahead, we'll also see that there are some NaN values in age and there are some NaN values in embarked column. Okay. So now let us go ahead and understand how we can check this. Okay. I'll show you the NaN values, but with the help of visualization also, with the help of CBOT. Okay. Now let us go ahead and try to understand. So this is my data set. Let me apply some exploratory data analysis. The first exploratory data analysis is that we'll start by checking out the missing data. In this, what we are going to do is that I'm going to use the SNS, that is seaborne, along with the heat map. Okay. The heat map actually helps us to see a value which is uniquely present. Suppose if I take a value that I'll put a condition that inside this heat map that my train, wherever is having the null values, okay, I will only make those records, okay, make those records have a different representation in color. Okay. So now you can see that over here, I'm writing sns.heatmap train.isNull. Okay. And this is my white tick labels as false. I don't want any Y label value. So I'm making it as false. And this C map is basically the representation that I want in basically in terms of color. So as soon as I execute this for the whole data set, now see, I'm just putting this condition. If it is null, that basically means if it is true, then only this particular condition will get applied. Now, when we go and see this particular data set, you can see over here, these are all my features name. And this yellow lines basically represent that these are having null values. Okay. So these are having null values. So now in this, you can see that the maximum number of null values are basically present in age column and cabin column. Okay. So here we can see that roughly 20% of the age data is missing. The proportion of age is missing is likely small enough for reasonable replacement with some form of imputation. Okay. Now imputation basically means that I want to replace this age with something else, but we'll discuss about it, how we will be replacing it. Okay. You don't have to worry about it. Now, one thing you note that, guys, I hope everybody has seen Titanic movies data set. Okay. The reason why age and cabin are basically missing, because after the Titanic accident incident, right, they were not able to collect that particular information because many people died. And that is the reason we find so many empty values in the case of age and cabin. Okay. So what we'll do is that we'll try to do some more exploratory data analysis, because I need to change this particular values. I need to replace this particular values with something else. Okay. Now the reason I have to replace it, because understand that I cannot just drop this whole record in this particular problem statement, because age can play a very important factor in a particular machine learning use case. So what I'll do is that I'll try to find out a replacement mechanism in this so that I can use some statistical method and try to replace some age value with some statistical mean, median, or mode. Okay. So let us just go ahead and try to do more exploratory data analysis. Now, first of all, in order to replace the age with something else, okay, we need to focus on which type of people have actually come. Okay. Basically, if you go and see in the case of gender, right, gender, we have basically male and female, and you know that male will be having a different age group, female will be having a different age group. Now it may also have, you may also have a situation that if you want to replace those value with mean, okay, so you can also consider the passenger class, because remember, guys, if you have seen the Titanic movie data set, Titanic movie, at that time, what has happened is that more people from the passenger class, third class, is basically, they have died, right? Because they were stuck in the basement itself. Whereas the higher class people were actually getting evacuated in the boat, right? So because of that, you should make sure that if you are replacing those values of the age with mean, what mean you have to take, whether you have to take of the passenger class third or passenger class second, that also exploratory data analysis has to be done. You can't just take directly the mean. Okay? If you just take directly the mean, definitely the accuracy will not be that. So to begin with, what I'll do is that I will just try to do an exploratory data analysis with respect to the count plot. In seaborn, we have count plot, and here I'll try to understand how many people have survived. Okay. Whereas how many people have survived in case of male and female. Oh, sorry. Initially, I'll just see how many people have survived, and then I'll try to apply that with respect to male and female, and then I'll try to apply with respect to passenger class also. Now just let us go ahead and see this. So here I have my count plot. Here you can see that I have zero. Zero is basically people who survived. Sorry, one is basically the people who have not survived, and zero is basically the people who have survived. So here you can see that maximum number of people have basically survived. Survived zero and one. Okay, survived one basically means that person has survived. Survived zero basically means that the person has not survived. Sorry for the confusion. Let us go ahead and try to understand with respect to the survived, who has survived more, whether male have survived more or female have survived more. I'm going to just use the same count plot. In the x-axis, I'm going to give my survived column. And this hui parameter is basically on which parameter I'm trying to check the people who have survived or not survived. So here, this is based on the sex. In sex, I have male and female. And obviously, you can see that in survived, you can see that male people, the value when it was zero, right? That basically means the person has not survived. And in this, you can see that the actor, right? Our actor in Titanic movie, basically so many males have actually died. Okay. The people who have not survived, a maximum number of people who had died were basically males. Okay. Whereas in people who had actually survived, maximum number of people who were saved, who survived were basically females. Okay. And less number of males. Now this is giving you a more idea about what kind of replacement you can basically use in the case of age. Okay. Now I just like to add one more thing with respect to survived. I'll also try to see that whether we had any, what is the count plot with respect to the passenger class. Okay. So this, instead of hui as sex, I'm using it as passenger class. Now, if I go ahead and see, now here you can see that with respect to this blue color basically indicates my passenger class one, passenger class 2, passenger class 3. Now you can see that from the people who had survived from the passenger class 3, it is very less. Passenger class 2 is good. Passenger class 1 is the most. Okay. So the people you can see over here, passenger class 1 had survived. Since they were in passenger class 1, they got easily the help of boats and they were able to just run. But in the case of 0, you can see that passenger class 3 had died more. It was more than 350 people. Okay. Now the next thing is that I'll just try to see some plotting, some more plotting. And these all are a part of exploratory data analysis. I'll also try to plot my age in the form of kernel distribution and kernel density estimator to just find out that how my age was actually distributed. So for that, I'm just going to use this dist plot. And you can see that I'm just using train of age dot drop NA. I have to do the drop NA because otherwise this function will give me an error. You can just download this particular code and see. Now you can see that here is my data set. And if you see in the next line, it will be having a normally distributed kind of graph. Okay. And this also gives you an idea that what were the people of maximum average of age present in that particular board. Okay. Now, similarly, what I'll do, since I have got this much information, right? Now the next thing is that I will try to replace the passenger class with the age. Now see everybody. This is a kind of box plot. Now, box plot gives you a lot of information with respect to for the passenger class 1, okay? What was the 25 percentile age? What was the 50 percentile age? What was the 75 percentile age? Okay? That basically means that, well, if you don't know about percentile, guys, I've already created a video. So, this basically shows you that what is the median of the age that you had, okay? So with respect to passenger class 1, you can see that we had somewhere around 37. Whereas in passenger class 2, we had the median age somewhere around 29. Whereas in passenger class 3, we had somewhere around 23. Now what I will do is that I'll just apply a condition wherein I'll just say that if the person belongs to passenger class 1, right? I will replace that age with the median of this particular, with the mean of this particular passenger in class one. So I'll just take up this particular value that is 37 and I'll replace it. Then I'll put another condition saying that if the passenger class is two, at that time what I'll do is that I'll replace that value with the median of, with the mean of this particular passenger class. Similar in the case of passenger class three. So here it is. I'll just create a function which is called as impute age columns. And here you have age columns of zero, passenger class of one. This is the parameter. I'm just providing two features and I'll just put this particular condition. This condition is the most important. I'll say that if pd dot is null is age, okay, if they are null values, I'll just put a condition if p class is equal to one. Okay, if it is one, I'll return 37. If it is two, I'll return 29. How this 37, 29 is coming, I'm just basically verifying this particular box plot. And then finally, I'll be replacing it, all the values with respect to the age. Okay. Once I apply this particular function, this is basically my imputing function. I am just applying. I'm seeing the box plot. I know the mean values. I'm replacing it with that. That's it. Now, this is where I'm considering my age. I'm replacing my age completely. But always remember that this should be critically done. You know, you should understand each and every behavior. Now you see that how many exploratory data analysis we have applied in this case. Okay. So you have to go ahead with that and try to do this. The other column that I basically have is cabin. So once I do the replacement, I'll just go over here. You can see that this is my function. And then I'll apply this particular function in my training data set. And now when I again plot the heat map, you can see that I don't have any null values in my age. Okay. And this is basically fixed. Now, the next thing is that my cabin is having so many null values. What should I do? See, more than 70 to 80% is having null values. So what should I do? Should I drop it directly or should I try to replace with something else? See, in case of cabin class, since what I have done is that for this particular problem statement is that I find out, I see that there are a lot of null values over here. So what I have done is that I have just directly dropped this particular column. The reason I'm dropping this particular column is that I don't want to derive some values in this particular thing because I'm not a domain expert of the Titanic dataset, obviously. So what I do is that I try to drop this, but definitely you can come up with different approach. Okay. Based on the passenger class, you can come up with different classes and you can try to group it and replace those NaN value with something else. You can try it out. You can try it out definitely. And there is a lot of, Kaggle competition that have happened in Titanic data set, and you can get a lot of information on Kaggle and you try to see that what all features they have tried to replace with the cabin itself. But this was all about, you know, handling the null values with the help of statistical method, you know, and then later on after you replace this null values, you just have to build a logistic regression model, which I have already created so many videos. You can refer this particular GitHub, this particular Jupyter Notebook code materials, I've put up in the GitHub link. I've shared it in the description box. Just go through this from top to bottom. You'll get a lot of information. So I hope you like this particular videos, guys. This was basically about managing missing data, which is a part of feature engineering, which is the most important part in any machine learning use case. I hope you like this particular videos, guys. Please do subscribe to the channel if you have not subscribed. I'll see you all in the next video. Have a great day ahead. Thank you.